Let us offer our consecration to the Lord. Lord, we offer up to you this day, this last workday before the weekend. We ask that we may open our hearts to you. We ask that we may seek to love you, honor you, and obey you in all that you seek, that we may glorify your name and show the world the importance that you teach us. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. You know, there's something that fascinates me, and I've been thinking about this for a while. And what it is we see the, you know, the whole history of the world, and we see everything else. And I really think that people who are believers, such as those of us who are involved in this show here, I'm speaking to you, you're listening to me, we have a deeper insight into the world around us. And I think that insight grows deeper as people who are outside the believing circle turn more and more away from the Lord. For example, a long time ago, well, not too long, you know, several years ago, I started to notice that there was a turning away from charity in our society. Charity not even giving money to help people, but charity of how we respect one another. And if you look, the people will say our society is divided. They're trying to ask why. Well, I looked at that a long time. I saw this was coming a long time ago. And one of the things was this turning away from charity. So you had a choice at that point. You could either embrace charity, try to be kind to one another, or you could reject it and start following the rule that people follow when they turn away from that. Try to love one another. And that is the famous rule of Machiavelli, the ends justify the means. And so you're seeing a lot of that in our society. And when people turn away from seeking to do what's best for another, they will fall into the ends justify the means. And that's what idolatry breaks itself into. The ends justify the means. So let me give you an example. Let's go back to Hammurabi's code. Now remember, Hammurabi's code is a code that seeks to civilize the way society was. So the code was simply an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. And today we look at that as barbaric. But at the time, that was considered civilized. And the reason is because people would say, you know, two eyes for an eye, or two eyes for a stolen wallet, or a hand for so whatever. And so it's an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Okay. And again, we look at that as being barbaric. But why would someone put together rules that were so what we would say barbaric? The ends justify the means. What is it that Jesus says? Love your enemy. Do good to those who persecute you. Well, the ends don't justify the means there in the same way. So Jesus is calling us to a whole different standard. He's calling us to a whole different way of living. And the more we seek to live as people who try to follow the law of God, which is to love one another, love God and love one another, the more you're going to turn away from the ends justify the means. The more you reject God, the more you are going to embrace the ends justify the means. So what you may be seeing in the society is not, in the United States, not a division between Democrats and Republicans, between the conservatives and liberals, but between those who embrace the ends justify the means and love one another as I have loved you. Jesus' words. So you see that radical difference that is happening. Well, in today's gospel, if you have your daily missal, you'll see that Jesus is saying, are you looking at the signs? And he calls people hypocrites, that you can read the signs of the weather, but you can't read the signs of the times. Now, one of the things that's been going on in our society right now, in our world right now, is the whole discussion about the use of nuclear weapons. And people will say that hasn't been spoken of since the Cuban Missile Crisis. I would disagree. And here's why I say that. I would disagree. I think we are beyond the Cuban Missile Crisis. Because what was the Cuban Missile Crisis? The Soviets were going to put nuclear missiles in Cuba, and John Kennedy said, oh, no, you're not. Now, we have a reverse of that now because we have nuclear missiles that line the Russian border, which is one of the reasons why Putin is so much against NATO. But we've got that. So we've got literally the exact opposite situation. But what was the situation? It was very simple that Kennedy said, get the missiles out of Cuba or we'll go to nuclear war. Essentially, I can't really quote him, of course, but there was this big standoff that happened in light of that. We're not in that position. We're in the position where people are literally worried that we could go into a nuclear war. We're beyond the Cuban Missile Crisis. Okay. So what are the signs? And the other question is, how did we get here? And we got here by A, the ends justify the means. When people turn away from the Lord, what do they embrace? The ends justify the means. And B, people saying that using nuclear weapons is a viable alternative, which it never is. Not if you're going to embrace the teachings of Christ. So we're actually in this separation, which Jesus is talking about in a different context, of course, where you have people who are lost in the ends justify the means. And part of it is because a lot of people have turned away from the Lord, so they have no other alternative. And they just follow what the crowd says, and the crowd says, ends justify the means, and we're just as barbaric as Hammurabi in the name of civility. We'll talk more on the other side of the break. You're listening to St. Anthony Overnight from St. Anthony Parish in Allston, Massachusetts. I want to call your attention to Catholic TV, which offers great faith-filled, family-friendly programming 24 hours a day. You can find your cable channel at www.getcatholictv.com, and you can watch online, on the free apps, or check out the YouTube channel. Daily Mass, Rosaries, the Divine Mercy Chaplet, and the Our Lady of Perpetual Help Novena are all available online and on demand. Check out CatholicTV.com. And don't forget our own website, CatholicAudioMedia.com. That's CatholicAudioMedia.com. Check out our website. Check out the archives of the show. Check out our Substack newsletter. You can do all kinds of things over there at CatholicAudioMedia.com. Don't forget, you have a standing invitation to our 10 o'clock a.m. Mass every single Sunday. And invite your friends to listen to our program. Invite your friends to Mass. Do the same. 10 o'clock a.m. Mass at St. Anthony Parish in Allston, Massachusetts. Well, we're looking at this powerful message here, and we're looking at what's being said, and what Jesus is saying is, are you reading the signs of the times? And one of the fascinating things I've noticed is all people have been worrying for some time, and they're saying, are we at the end of the world? Can I answer that question? No, I can't. So please don't ask me. But they're saying, are we at the end of the world? But here's one of the things to understand, because people are always looking for the Jesus or the Lord sending signs of earthquakes and famines and all this other stuff. And maybe those are there. But those signs, if they are even there, and I'm not saying they are, would be warning signs to us to get back to the Lord. So they wouldn't be punishments, as some people say. They'd be warning signs to get back to the Lord. But look at where we are. How did we get here? We didn't get here by the Lord sending some kind of disaster like Sodom and Gomorrah. We got here by people turning away from the Lord and making disastrous choices. And that is what leads people here. And what is the greatest origin source of disastrous choices? The ends justify the means. If you look at all the great horrors that happened in the 20th century, at the very bottom of it was the ends justify the means. And don't forget, at the bottom of this also is one of the great sources of the ends justify the means, Saul Alinsky's Rules for Radicals. But people say there's this evil that has taken over the church. Well, Saul Alinsky's Rules for Radicals, as I've told you before, says emulate the devil to get what you want. Well, if you do that, you might as well be using some form of demonic device that opens you up to the devil, because what are you called to do? Emulate the devil. Do what the devil does. Emulate the devil. Connect yourself to the devil to get what you want. And people say, well, where did this evil come from? Well, where do you think the evil came from? Where do you think it came from? And again, what's at the very bottom of this? The ends justify the means. Let's go back to the original temptation as I'm thinking of this. What is it that the devil does to Eve? The devil says, if you eat of the apple, you will be like gods. But we're not supposed to eat of the apple. He told us not to. The ends justify the means. If you eat of the apple and you disobey God, then you'll be a god anyway, so it doesn't matter, is essentially what he's saying. Always be aware of that and listen to it yourself. And when you're listening to political discourse, when you're listening, and it doesn't matter which party you're listening to, be attentive to that whole, the ends justify the means, and you're reading the signs of the times. Even when people are worried about, will there be a use of a nuclear weapon? The ends justify the means. That's the only way you can justify using a nuclear weapon. Did someone sabotage the Nord Stream pipeline? The ends justify the means. You could no more do that, possibly putting people in danger of environmental, meaning cold, and not being able to respond to the cold unless you believe the ends justify the means. So you see, those signs are there. I'm not saying they're the signs of the end of the world, but they're the signs of the reality of what happens when people turn away from the Lord. When they turn away from the Lord, they walk down a completely different path, a completely different way of thinking. And one of their ways of thinking is the ends justify the means, where we are called to act in a way that demonstrates love of God and love of neighbor. And in that way, the ends never justify the means. Have yourself a blessed day. We will see you on Monday and enjoy the weekend. If you would like to support our program, please consider a donation to St. Anthony Parish in Allston, Massachusetts. There are several ways to consider this. One is to purchase any of our merchandise, which you can find at the shopping tab at CatholicAudioMedia.com. That's CatholicAudioMedia.com. There are coffee mugs there. There's also my latest book, Encounter Christ in Your Humanity, all of which you can find at the shopping tab at CatholicAudioMedia.com. You can also donate to the show directly through either the Donate tab, also at CatholicAudioMedia.com, or by sending a donation through the U.S. Postal Service with your questions and comments at 43 Holton Street, Allston, Massachusetts, 02134. That's St. Anthony Parish, 43 Holton Street, Allston, Massachusetts, 02134. Finally, the best way you can support our parish is to attend Mass on Sundays at 10 o'clock and be a part of our parish. We thank you for any support you would like to give to St. Anthony Parish in Allston, Massachusetts, the sponsoring parish for this media outreach to Catholics and other Christians in the WROL, WEZE, and podcast listening audience. In Cristo vivimos.